Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about triazolam. What is this drug triazolam? The suffix lam indicates that this drug is one of the benzodiazepine. Many of the benzodiazepines are having the suffix palm, and few of the benzodiazepines such as triazolam, midazolam, alprazolam, all these are having the suffix lam, which indicates they are benzodiazepines. And here the prefix triazole indicates that this drug is having triazole ring system, which is fused with benzodiazepine. So triazolam is a fused benzodiazepine, or simply triazolobenzodiazepine. Now this drug can be used in the condition such as insomnia, where there is lack of sleep or sleep disturbances can be observed within the patients. In such conditions, triazolam can be used as hypnotic to reduce the symptoms of insomnia, and it increases the quality of the sleep as well as induction of the sleep. And this drug is available under various brand names such as Halcion, Trilam, Hypom, Epotriazo. Under different brand names, this triazolam is available. But this drug is only used for acute treatment. So triazolam is indicated for 7 to 10 days treatment. If insomnia is not managed by this triazolam after 10 days, then this drug is considered ineffective. So for the short-term treatment of insomnia, triazolam can be used, which is a triazolobenzodiazepine. So today in this video, we are going to see how this triazolam acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of triazolam. And here we can observe the benzodiazepine ring is fused with triazole ring. Triazole is nothing but the 5-member ring system with 3 nitrogens. Let us give the numbering to this fused benzodiazepine. Based on the IUPAC rules, we have to start the numbering from this carbon, which is the topmost atom in the ring structure of fused benzodiazepine. Now this is 1, then 2, then 3, 4, 5. So here in the benzodiazepine, the nitrogen is at the 4th position, but now in this fused ring system, it is at the 5th position. And this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So electron withdrawing group is generally present in the 7th position, but in the fused ring systems, it is present at the 8th position. Now let us give the name for this structure. So simply it is a benzodiazepine with 1st and 4th positions nitrogen. So we can write this as 1,4 benzodiazepine. This 1,4 benzodiazepine is fused with a triazole ring system with 3 nitrogens at 1st, 2nd and 4th positions. So 1,2,4 triazole ring system. These two ring systems are fused by 3rd and 4th position of triazole and A side of benzodiazepine. So we can write this as 4,3A. So this is the naming of fused ring system. 1,2,4 triazolo, 4,3A, 1,4 benzodiazepine. Now let us see the side chains present at the different positions. 8th position chlorine group is present, so 8 chloro. 6th position phenyl ring is present along with a chlorine group at ortho position. So 6-2 chlorophenyl, and 1st position methyl group is present, so 1 methyl. And finally saturation is present at the 4th position, so 4H. That is a complete name of triazolam. Now let us see how this drug acts. Within the CNS, GABA A receptors are expressed, which are ionotropic receptors. They are made up of different subunits such as alpha, beta, gamma. And these GABA A receptors are pentameric in nature. They are made up of 5 subunits. Now, on these GABA A receptors, GABA can act to produce inhibitory response. Now, triazolam acts as GABA A receptor modulator. It can bind to an accessory site on GABA A receptors such that it can increase the binding of GABA on the GABA A receptors. Now, when GABA binds to these GABA A receptors, it opens the chloride channels. So, chloride can enter into the cell where it produces hyperpolarization. Since chlorine is having the negative charge, now the cells are getting hyperpolarization resulting in inhibitory response. Because of this hyperpolarization, the neuronal excitability within the CNS is going to be reduced, which increases the induction of sleep as well as induction of sedation within the patients. But along with sleep and sedation, Triazolam can also produce some loss of memory, so it can increase the amnesia. It can also increase the muscle relaxation, which may result in some ataxia within the patients. In this way, triazolam acts as positive allosteric modulator on GABA A receptors. What are the precautions? Just we have seen that triazolam can be used for the treatment of sleep disturbances. These sleep disturbances may be observed due to any acute effect, such as change in the location or any history of traveling or due to any anxiety. So because of any of these reasons, insomnia may be developed for short term. Otherwise, these sleep disturbances can also be observed in few of the psychotic disorders, and it may be a manifestation of psychosis. So now triazolam can be used as hypnotic. It can reduce the symptoms of sleep disturbances within 7 to 10 days of treatment. But when these symptoms are not reduced even after treatment after 10 days, then the insomnia may be due to any psychotic symptoms. So this drug is not reducing the psychosis. It is only used as hypnotic, working within 10 days. So in those patients without any improvement of sleep or further increase in the insomnia, then this triazolam should not be used. But any other pathological symptoms such as psychosis, depression may be monitored within the patients. Similarly, this drug can produce some complex behavior within the patients. Particularly, this behavior can be observed when this drug is combined with alcohol. So in few of the patients, we can observe some sleep driving. They can drive the vehicles during the sleep, and some strange behavior such as preparing the food and eating the food without full consciousness. All this stereotype behavior can be observed with this triazolam, particularly along with alcohol. As a benzodiazepine, triazolam can increase the sedation as well as drowsiness within the patients, and it can also produce some confusion, which is more important in the elder patients. Again, along with the alcohol, otherwise along with CNS depressants and opioids, this sedation and drowsiness is more pronounced with triazolam. That's why when this drug is going to be prescribed as hypnotic, the patient should be given precaution such that when they are driving the vehicles, care should be taken, and when they are working with machinery, again care should be taken in order to avoid any accidents and injuries because of high sedation and drowsiness within the patients. What are the side effects? Just like other benzodiazepines, triazolam can produce some drowsiness, dizziness, somnolence, sleepiness in the patients, and some sedation and confusion can be observed. It can also produce some memory impairment resulting in amnesia, and some visual disturbances can also be observed. It can produce some headache and ataxia. Some loss of balance can be observed because of muscle relaxation. And finally, this drug can also produce fatigue as another important side effect. How it is given? This drug is available as tablets at a strength of 0.125 mg as well as 0.25 mg. The initial dose of the drug is started at 0.25 mg given at bedtime. The dose may be slowly increased up to 0.5 mg again given at bedtime, but the low dose should be used in order to avoid sedation and drowsiness within the patients. In the elders, the dose of the drug should be reduced. So triazolam is given at a dose of 0.125 mg given at bedtime. So that's about this drug triazolam, which is a triazolobenzodiazepine. This drug is used for the short-term treatment of insomnia for around 7 to 10 days. And if the symptoms of insomnia are not improved after 10 days, then other CNS disorders should be considered within the patients. Sedation, drowsiness are the important side effects that are produced by this triazolam, which should be closely monitored. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.